So far, this video series has been all about the theory of digital electronics. In this video, which will be the final one for now, I'm going to show a practical application using a shift register. This is used to increase the number of ports available on the GPI of the Raspberry Pi or Arduino to drive a pair of 7-segment LED displays. This is based upon flip-flops and registers, which I explained in my earlier video. If you're not already familiar with the D-type flip-flop, then there is a link in the description, so you can view that video first. In the previous video, I finished with the 8-bit register, also known as an 8-bit latch. This is going to be part of the internal circuitry that we're going to be using, so it's important to understand this. It's also part of the output stage of a number of digital integrated circuits. In the diagram, you can see the 8D flip-flops, which store the information when sent a clock, which may be called a register or latch clock. When there is a clock signal, then the inputs to the ports marked D will go to the outputs marked Q and will latch there until the next clock signal. The next thing I wanted to look at is from a practical perspective. The shift register is a useful circuit for taking serial data and to convert that to a parallel output. I've used this in the past when I've run out of ports on an Arduino, and this example will show how it can be used with both an Arduino and a Raspberry Pi. The shift register works by serial data entering into the first flip-flop. When the first clock signal is received, that data becomes the output of the first flip-flop. Then, when the next clock signal comes in, that passes that data through to the second flip-flop, and the new data is shifted into the first. After 8 clock cycles, then the first bit of data has reached the right-hand side, and the outputs represent the 8 bits of serial data converted to a parallel output. There is one problem with this. Whilst the output is now correct, whilst the data is being shifted in, then the data would have been visible on the output, which would have been incorrect. What's the solution? Well, it's to put the output of the shift register through a latch, which I mentioned earlier. This is a fairly crude drawing. I've just overlapped the shift register from the latch from the earlier diagram. This is how circuits are designed, but normally the designs are created using a circuit design tool, or at least a 2D drawing tool. The 3D effect has been added to make this a little bit more interesting than basic black and white drawings. But for the next drawings, I'll be switching to a traditional 2D diagrams. One thing you'll notice is that there are two different clocks. These are separate clocks. The first may be known as the serial clock, and the second stage would be the latch clock, or otherwise known as the register clock. The latch clock would only pulse when all 8 bits are shifted in, so it would run at 1/8 the speed of the serial clock. This entire circuit is included in an integrated circuit, such as the SN74HC595. Next, I'll show you a real use example, how this can be used to drive a 7-segment LED display using only 3 GPIO data pins instead of 8 that would normally be needed. In fact, this could save even more, as the shift registers are daisy chained using the serial output, allowing multiple displays to be connected without needing any more pins. This is the complete circuit using the SN74HC595 shift register. Also included are ULN2803A Darlington transistor ICs, which act as a buffer stage so that there is enough current for the LED displays. This is the actual circuit diagram for the abstract version shown at the start of this video. The blue block on the left shows the Raspberry Pi GPIO connector. This is turned on its side so that it fits better in the image. Based on the 3D image of the Pi in the bottom left, if you turn that image 90 degrees clockwise, then that would line up with the GPIO ports. In addition to the power supply, which is from the 3.3 volt power supply for VCC1, there are 3 connections to the first shift register, which are the serial data out on GPIO 22, the serial clock on GPIO 23, and the register clock on GPIO 24. The bottom shift register is connected to the same clocks, but the serial data in comes from the serial data out from the first shift register. You can do this with any number of additional shift registers without needing any more ports on the GPIO, although it will take a little longer to update the displays. The eight parallel data outputs from the shift register go to the Darlington driver IC, which is able to drive the LEDs directly. There should be a second VCC, which could be taken from the GPIO on this particular circuit, but should be careful not to overload the power regulator built into the Raspberry Pi. This is connected to the 5-volt supply. There are 220 ohm resistors used to restrict the current to protect the LEDs. The diagram is quite small. You can download a PDF from my website, www.penguintutor.com/electronics/digital. It's also included in the second edition of my book, Learning Electronics with Raspberry Pi by Stuart Watkiss. You'll also find the source code on both my website and included in the book source code. Here you can see the circuit made upon a breadboard, and here it is in action in the form of a counter circuit which counts up from 0 to 99 using two extra large 7-segment LED displays. This next circuit is using the same as the Raspberry Pi version, but using the Arduino Maker board, such as the MKR0 and the MKR Wi-Fi boards. It's just the ports on the Arduino that are used, which are different to the Raspberry Pi. The main difference is in the code to run this program. The example for the Raspberry Pi was based around Python, whereas Arduino uses C. The source code is available from my website, www.penguintutor.com/electronics/digital. This is the same circuit as before, connected to the Arduino MKR0. The final thing I'll cover are some tips on choosing different components. There are lots of different options available depending upon your specific requirements. The two integrated circuits that I've used here are the 74HC595 shift register and the ULN2803A Darlington driver, which are commonly used by makers. The shift register is compatible with different voltage levels, and the Darlington drivers can handle a large current. The ULN2803A is actually able to handle a lot more than the LEDs used here. You could say this is over-engineered for the job, but for maker projects, it's a useful component that has multiple uses. One notable mention is a different shift register that I've used before, which is the TPIC6B595. This is a single integrated circuit based around the shift register, but it has open collector outputs. This means it can drive the LEDs directly without needing the extra buffer stage, so that uses half the number of integrated circuits and much less wiring. The problem is that the TPIC6B595 is designed for a 5-volt power supply with associated logic levels. The Raspberry Pi and the output from the Arduino MKR series is 3.3 volts, which does not guarantee a high enough voltage for a one output that the shift register requires. In reality, I've used the circuits using the TPIC6B595 connected to a Raspberry Pi, and it did work, but they do not meet the design specs, so there is a risk it may not. The TPIC6B595 reduces the number of components and wiring, but should only really be used for 5-volt logic. It is a good choice if you have a traditional format Arduino board, such as the Leonardo, which uses 5-volt logic levels. An alternative is to add a logic level shifter between the Raspberry Pi or Arduino and the shift register. This will introduce more components, but it would only be required for the three data lines entering the first shift register and could be created using individual MOSFETs instead of needing an integrated circuit, although that is an option as well. Choosing a component is about finding suitable alternatives, comparing them with the terms of their electrical characteristics through the datasheets to see which fits best with your project. You may also want to look at cost and availability, although for integrated circuits for one-off maker projects, that is not always an issue. This is the last video in this series for now. Although if you're interested in more of this kind of content, please give it a thumbs up or leave a comment about what you'd like to see. This video series has gone from the basics of logic gates to practical shift register and a working example circuit. If you found this useful, you may also like my book, Learn Electronics with Raspberry Pi by Stuart Watkiss, published by A-Press. If these videos are popular, then I'll look at adding some more videos on digital electronics in the future. So please subscribe to my channel to get notified of new videos, and if there is something you'd like me to cover on future videos, then let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching.